Hi, you guys. Jacqueline Jax for AVA Live Radio. I'm here with Instagram marketing tips for 2018 to grow quickly. I also am going to go over three major things that people who succeed on Instagram are doing differently than you, and how I get my Instagram posts to rank in the top posts. Interesting, right? This came off of some interesting things that we've been doing. I'm also going to be talking about the $1.80 Instagram strategy for faster growth that was put out by Gary Vaynerchuk. If you don't know him, go look him up. He's got some pretty interesting vlog videos on YouTube. They're pretty funny to watch. At this point, once you watch like 10 of them, you kind of know his ticket, you know what I mean? And if you're really a niche audience, you probably won't think that everything he does, because he does a lot with real estate people, might not be for you, but he's got some really great tips for getting started, and he definitely has an awesome work ethic. So with that being said, let's get into the video and start chatting, shall we? Now, I'm on Instagram Live with my peeps here because we just did a huge Instagram pod night, and we're doing it for 14 days right now on Instagram. There's about 50 people in it. I'm doing these trainings for them, and they are the artists that are launching music with AVA Live Radio. So part of being on our program is that you get some Instagram training. That's what we're doing this time around. So we're going to be doing that in April, May, and June. So if it's something that you really want to learn and you want to get really great at Instagram, you can watch these videos and also get into the pods. You can get that real meat and potatoes experience, you know, the full experience of what works and what doesn't, and you get some strategies personally from me. So happy to do that. It's really cool that we're doing it over there. So thank you to American Pride Magazine for sponsoring that. Otherwise, I would not be able to take the time to actually do this kind of training and these videos. Without them and their sponsorships continually on these artists, we would never be able to run the program that we do, because it's just impossible. It costs way too much to do it. And, you know, just putting on the whole program, between getting the artists in front of press releases and in front of people who matter, going back and forth and nurturing those relationships, that's a full-time job, by the way, and then handling the artist media pieces, creating the banners, doing the social media, reacting to comments, you know, and keeping everything alive, as well as planning the programs and making sure they all go off on time and get SEO listed, maintaining the blogs, maintaining the websites, all of that is what we do. There's so much that we do that we require a lot of people supporting us. So to the indie artists who do support us, we so appreciate you. And to American Pride Magazine and Shure and IK Multimedia and all of the wonderful brands that come along as we go through the year, we so cherish you and we love the relationship. So thank you so much for doing that for us. Now, don't forget to leave a comment below as I get going here and let me know what your favorite Instagram tips are. And if there's a strategy I can add to it, I will certainly do a video on it. If I think that you're maybe just a little off of what you need to be doing, that might be helpful too. I can leave you a comment back. So be sure to leave a comment. I also encourage you guys to leave valued comments wherever you go, whether it be on Instagram or YouTube, Facebook. The more value you add, the more likely people are to find you. And a lot of times I get artists and people saying, you know, I don't understand. I can't reach people. I can't get anybody to respond to me. And I look and I realize that, one, you don't answer your comments, and two, you don't reach out to anybody. Like, I don't even see comments on my stuff, barely. So, and you know, and you and I are in conversations all the time. So I think that the problem is that you don't spend enough time actually nurturing your audience and caring about your audience. That's the number one thing I notice everywhere. But aside from that, if you are trying and you do really want to do well here, it is a commitment. And if you're willing to commit, and if you're willing to actually put in that long-term energy into this goal, then you can do really, really well like the rest of us. And here's the thing. Spending time is the key, as Calvin Evans said. And he was just featured in American Pride Magazine, by the way, because he just did TED Talks. Now, that is a man that put in a lot of time and energy and knows what I'm talking about. Now he's just got to put time and energy into his social media pages. Hint, hint, Kevin. And we're helping him do that for sure. But here is the first thing. One is showing up. So the difference between the people that I notice that are doing really, really well that I'm working with and the people that aren't, one little piece of that puzzle aside from good content. It's a given, you have to have good content. You've got to have non-grainy photos, even if it's a selfie. We were just talking about that 2 seconds ago in Instagram stories. It has to not be grainy. It has to be a good quality, great lighting. So there's certain things that go into making a good picture, even if it's a camera photo. But aside from the content that you're sharing, you have to show up consistently. So if for instance, right now in the pod training, I asked everyone to get 14 pictures or 14 video clips or whatever it is together, even if they go on Instagram and they just say, hey guys, you know, it's Sunday, how are you doing today? I had a great weekend, da 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 da, right? I can't tell you of the 50 people I'm working with how many people failed to do that. They didn't do that one thing. And now they're wondering why they had no comments today on their Instagram posts, all right? So if you don't show up, then you're not going to reap rewards. And I don't understand why that part is not getting in. That to me is like, wow, basic 101, right? The people who are doing well, they're showing up big time. You have to have quality content and not just pictures of food unless you are foodogram. You have to be telling your narrative story and be doing it professionally on Instagram in order for this to make a difference. Now, I'm not saying that everybody has to launch a picture a day, but I can say that if you're not on Instagram for at least an hour a day, you're not going to grow. I also find that you're only as good as your last photo. So if nobody commented on the last photo, get it down, get it off of there, and try again. Now, there are certain things that you could do with that photograph or that image or that video to make this better and make it work for you. And here, no matter what stage you're at, is one of those things. One of the things is to find the right hashtags. This is why in the beginning, it's better to launch a photo a day or two photos a day, but only if you're willing to be on there for at least 30 minutes after you post that photo. And I highly recommend, if you really want to speed the growth, that you get on there 30 minutes before the photo. Now, if you want massive growth, and like one of you is asking me right now, how I can get to 1 million followers on Instagram to change my life, you are going to have to do all these things consistently every single day. Instagram is going to have to be your total jam, all right? It's going to have to be your number one priority if you want to get there. Now, the things with the hashtags, here's what you have to do. You right now have to spend 30 minutes today seeking out all of the hashtags that are relevant to the content that you want to be known for on Instagram. So if you are a singer and you're going to use this particular Instagram page to feature your music, then you should have music videos and images and talk about you being in the studio, pictures of you recording your music videos, clips from your music videos. You need to tell that story in those 9 posts. You need to have at least 1 fresh post a day as you're getting started. When you grow, if you decide not to put posts a day, that's up to you, but I highly recommend it. I used to in the beginning have a goal of like, I would launch a post and at first I just needed 50 likes and like 10 comments. Then I set my goal to 100 likes and 10 comments, and then 20 comments, and then 40 comments, until I would agree to post a new picture. That was my own goal, because I knew in my mind that I didn't stop working, even though I had another picture to post on Instagram, until I achieved that goal. And it wasn't about spamming people, it was about connecting with people, and connecting with enough people. Ever since I joined AVA Live Radio, I gained more Instagram and Twitter followers. Myron, hey Myron Cotton's in the house. Awesome, I love to hear that. And I do hear those stories all the time and I appreciate you guys. I wish somebody would take a screenshot of that for me so that I can post it out on Twitter and let everybody know, because I do try to take the time out to let you guys know about the feedback, even though, you know, we get it every day, and I so appreciate you. It's just that we don't have the manpower to post all the feedbacks, honestly. So screenshot me and send it, and I will make it travel. I will let everybody know. All right, so 30 tags is what's available to you when you post. So if you were going to do a strategy where you do it a post a day and then you worked really, really hard to get like 100 likes, 200 likes on the post and build from there and to get like 10 to 20 comments and make those into 40 comments because you answer the comments. So like if somebody leaves a comment and you answer, but you don't just say thanks, you actually answer and ask them a question, or you go to their page, you leave them a comment back, and then you go to your page and you answer them a question that has to do with their page. Now you've got a conversation, so you can easily take that 10 comments and make it 20 in less than 30 minutes, right? So that's huge, because now the algorithm sees that you have 20 comments on a recent post. And now your next post is going to be shown to more of your followers. So like that funnel, right? Where like if you were shown to this many people, at the bottom of the funnel is actually the super fan, right? You have to be shown to this many people for there to be levels of fanship, right? The people that see you, which is the impressions, the people that actually interact with you, which would be about midway through the funnel, and the people that stick around and actually like you and care about your stuff. Those are the people at the very bottom of the funnel. So if you offer this every single day and at the top of it is 30 hashtags and a post or two posts a day, then guess what? If that's one post plus 30 hashtags and then a second post at night with another 30 hashtags that are different and in your niche, you've just made your page a whole lot more relevant. And why wouldn't you do that? Because if you're going to work really hard at getting engagement and traction, why not utilize the system and get to as many people as you can by putting out great content? Now, you will probably say to me, oh, but I don't have enough pictures, or oh, but I don't have time, or oh, I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. Because if you're making those excuses, then you're dead anyway. So you know what? Don't even watch the rest of this video, because it's not going to do you any good if you're not going to invest in yourself and actually learn how to use your phone to take good pictures, or, you know, get on there and live stream. I mean, if you want to be in the entertainment business, but you can't talk to people, then hello, you know, that's not going to work out. Time to change careers. So like there's certain things that don't make sense when I hear complaints, right? And think about it. I mean, think about it, guys. You just got to be real. I mean, if you don't want to entertain people, you don't want to do pictures, you don't want to make music, you don't want to do any of the things that we're saying, then get lost and go find something else to do, because you're just making yourself miserable and you're wasting everybody's time. All right, so the next thing is finding the right hashtags, the right ones. Do you guys know how to find the right ones? I'm asking my Instagram people. All right, the reason why there are some hashtags that will do great for you and some that won't is it depends on the current position that your Instagram page is in. So if you're just getting started and you have less than 1,000 followers, do not try for hashtags that have more than 500,000 posts on them. And you'll see a little post number. So when you search a hashtag at the top, you'll see the top posts and you'll see a number. If that number is above 100,000, you will never rank there until you get going consistently and you're posting every day and you've got traction going on. So try and find hashtags that are less posted on so that you can use my system to get into the top posts for a longer period of time. Because when you stay there, and this has to do with one of the upcoming strategies that I'm going to tell you in just a second, when you stay there, the people that will interact with you will become your followers and interact with your account and the posts that they see. Now, here's how it works. And I know for some of you, you're probably, wow, I don't understand this. You know, I don't get how this works. Say you do a post and you put 30 hashtags in it. Say your account is new and it doesn't have a lot of traction yet. Say when you do post, you get maybe 5 to 10 likes and you get maybe 2 comments. And then you turn that 2 comments into 4 comments because you actively commented back. So now you've got a situation where you don't have much going on, but you need to get more going on. So say you go out there, and this is the $1.80 Instagram strategy that Gary Vee talks about. Say you go out there and you go to the top posts in the hashtags that you would like to rank in, and you start looking at each one of those posts and leaving a quality interaction, Quality interaction, by the way, is not fireballs. It's not five claps. It's not just a wave. It is at least 4 to 6 words. Now, if you can't figure out 4 to 6 words to write about an interaction, about a post, even if it's, wow, that picture is amazing, I really love the content, when did you get started? If you can't take the time to write that, you're never going to reach a million people on Instagram because nobody is going to care about you. You have got to get people to care about who you are and be inquisitive about who you are. And that doesn't mean that you're going to go and say, hey, like for like, follow for follow. That's not going to work either. That's not a quality comment. It's actually considered spam. And when Instagram sees that, who is owned by Facebook, by the way, they're going to just declare your account a spam bot. And then you won't get seen no matter what you do. So don't get yourself into that habit. Leave a quality comment on at least 10 posts. Now, here's the $1.80 strategy. It's considered like 2 cents. If you leave your 2 cents on 10 posts, 10 or 9, was it 9 or 10 top trending Instagram posts, I think it's 10, then in the relevant hashtags that you want to qualify for, then those people and their followers, the people that are constantly interacting with those posts, are going to see that. They're going to think to themselves, wow, this guy's interesting or this girl's interesting, and they actually are a quality Instagrammer. They're not spamming the post. They're really genuinely interested in the content on Instagram, and they're obviously very active. And this is the mentality of people who read comments. They're looking for people that add quality to other people's posts. Those are the people that get the most follows, and therefore they do well. So see, by giving to others, right, and participating in others and actually being interested in people and being interested in social media, you get back what your goal is. You get back what you're looking to do. So how to choose the right hashtags depends on your account at this current time. Try to find things in your niche that are relevant to your post and take the time to make a list of 30 of those, and then take the time to make another list of 30 ones that would apply to a video post or the different kinds of posts that you're deciding to put on in the next week or so. Keep them on your phone so that you can copy and paste them into the first comment section or into the description box below the comment. Now, the reason why you don't want to just post them into the comment is because Instagram considers that spam, so they are not going to qualify those posts into the top posts unless they get a ton of engagement. But if you don't naturally get engagement, then you just shot yourself in the foot, right? Yes. So move it down with some periods, with some emojis, whatever it is, or put it in the first comment section. And that way you have the exposure from the Instagram hashtags, and as you go and do your work after you've posted, and the work is coming up, I'm going to tell you what to do, then you now have a post that is possibly going to qualify for 30 hashtags. And I showed you guys the other day that I literally get every single one of my posts into the top posts on Instagram. Every one of them ranks for at least 10 of my 30 hashtags. And it stays there because I look back as I'm searching hashtags and looking for, actually I'm looking for our artist to see if I'm ranking you so that I can take a screenshot and send it to you. So when we rank you, it's all good. Now I want to show you somebody that got ranked today that posted as a result of our pod. And this is really exciting because it's right here on the page. This is one of the guys in our pod. He posted this photo today. You can see, I can't move the thing up, but you can see if you go to it, and I'll tell you who it is. He is actually ranking right now, which is exciting because I want to tell him about this, in a hashtag called recording artists that has over 700,000 posts. Now, even though his account has, it's Step Back Jay the Rapper. His account has 11,000 followers, but he's ranking in the top, the number one spot for a post with 700,000 people. Woohoo! So that is cool. Now, the tips that I'm giving you on video and right now is the reason why that's happening for him. He's in my Instagram pods, so he's just learning about this stuff right now at this present time. I've got him for 14 days to get him to understand the algorithm as it exists right now in this moment in time. I'm not gonna promise you that it's gonna exist tomorrow. I'm not gonna promise you that it's gonna exist, you know, 5 months from now. I'm probably gonna have to make a whole nother set of videos. So you better subscribe to me because you don't wanna miss out. But I can promise you that you can do this with my system. And I'm giving you this information. Now let me show you what is also great, is he is also in the number one spot for the hip hop hashtag that has over 1 million subscribers to the hashtag. It's got 1 million posts. It's got 1.588 million posts. And he's the number one post right now. And we just did this at 8 p.m. tonight. Yeah, that is good, right? It's so exciting. I love it. I'm like so terribly excited about it. Now, if you look under the post, you're going to see people from my pod supporting the post and all that we did there to support him. And he was on it. He answered every single conversation. He went to every single one of the people in the pod and he made comments on their comments and on their posts. He was active. This is his reward. You see now, you get rewarded for doing things right and doing things correctly and doing things differently than anyone else. I know I sound like a pain in the butt. And I know that when I went into my pods tonight and I said, here's 3 tips for you guys to do better because you really, you know, like you're doing good, but you could do so much better. I don't want to hear from you that I couldn't do this tonight because it's Sunday night and I needed to spend time with this person, or I couldn't do this tonight for 30 minutes because I just had, you know, family matters. You had all day to make a post, and it literally takes how long to stick it on your Instagram page? And then how long does it take to leave 10 comments on 10 people's things? I mean, I just don't get that. I don't understand. I'm not understanding why it's not important to you if you're complaining that you're not doing well. Do you get that? Right? Like, you answer that question for me. If you are here watching this video and you want to do well on social media, but you can't give it 30 minutes of your time for 14 days out of 360 days to learn it and just to keep that going. And if you want to get to 1 million people, you can't give it 3 times a day. I mean, you want so much, but you're willing to give so little. That is why you're not doing well. And I can honestly say that, listen, it's okay if you don't do well, but don't complain about it. Don't make this a goal and make this something that I hear people saying, oh yeah, but I can't, or this didn't work, or, you know, I didn't gain enough from the information. How can you say that when you're not doing the work? You get it? Like, I see the hearts. I see you guys saying yes. And I see, actually, that's a great idea, creating your own unique hashtags. I love that, buddy. That's a great idea. And we do it for AVA Live Radio. All the artists should do it for their own content. Actually, you know what they do it with? They do it for, like, Vlogmas, and they do it for special projects. So, like, if I were doing, like, for this Instagram video, since I'm doing a series of like 4 or 5 of them, which might turn out to be a little more, we could actually create our own hashtag. And so then every single post to do with that, in like if we did extended content, it could actually rank and do it. But I think mostly it would be good for instance, there is a YouTuber that I watch, and this is a good example of a custom hashtag. It is Neistat. So Casey Neistat has a new YouTube series that he's doing on his channel that is I think it's called 368. Yeah, it's called 368. So if he did a hashtag that was NiceStat368, because it's like a series that's going to be like this whole year, but it's separate from the other content that could be circulating about him, I think that if he had his own hashtag and his own Instagram account just to feature NiceStat368, I think that all the fans of those videos and that series, because it's like a film series, it's kind of like watching, you know, like Game of Thrones or something, then that's where that custom hashtag would really be valuable. I could see that would be like amazing, because then now the hashtag can become a brand, and the hashtag can spawn t-shirts and merchandise, and all of the fans of the videos, like the 1.2 million people that are watching the video in the first 24 hours, they could buy merchandise for it. That would be awesome. So the hashtag could be part of that. That's just a little brainstorming, and I think that would work out really, really well. We should send him that idea. Maybe he's got a store. I don't know. I never even thought of it. All right. So weighing up your competition is definitely part of that hashtag thing. So you can see where Step Back Jay the Rapper has 11,000 followers on his Instagram page. He posted the post today. He posted a post yesterday. I haven't checked the hashtags to see how his post yesterday is doing, but both the posts did really, really well. You see how he's already ranking on day two? Day two, he's ranking in really good hashtags. So that just goes to show you that there is no excuse. And literally, it's a phone picture. It's not even like, it's bright, it's Florida. It's like semi-grainy, but it's clear, you know? So it's a good selfie. And he's got his sunglasses on. You can see the palm tree in the selfie. It's cool. I like it. So that is all it really takes to rank. So now that is going to perform for him and keep performing all week. It's not going to stop performing. Now that we kickstarted it, we've got enough comments on there, it's in top posts, people are going to start engaging with him. And because he used a really good photo, it kind of tells his story a little bit. It makes it interesting. I thought the photo was something that you would be like, yeah, let me go check it out and see. And if you saw more photos from that vein and more content that you could engage with and lots of good words, like he said, what you waiting for? Brand new track in my bio. Give it a listen. And then the next one was him at the beach. And he said, this is my mood. I have a new song out on YouTube. The link's in my bio, give it a listen, but like it's a beach picture and he's just sitting at the beach. So that's the least amount of commenting that you could do. You could do so much more with it. Now, some of the other ones that I noticed got a lot more comments were the people who shared words of wisdom or inspiration. Now, if you share words of wisdom or inspiration or just part of your thought process of the day on your post, this is a really great strategy for soliciting comments, commentary, and being able to further the conversation forward. Because when that post ends up in top posts and people read it to find out what you're all about because it's existing by itself, then it's up to your comment to really make a difference whether they're going to comment or not. The more inspirational the comment is and the more interesting the comment is, the more likely you are to get to that really great core follower faster. And the reason why is because if you're throwing in a bunch of people into the top of the funnel and those people are inspired by your words, then they are going to shoot right down and become your core follower, your big serious fan quickly, because they identify with the picture already or the video. But most of all, you just made them think. And when you just make them think, they're going to comment because you've just engage their brain. And it's fascinating because you kind of like lead people into being able to give you a comment that way. You know, like you feed them. You feed them. And when you feed them, they have an idea or something to say and that you don't have to think of it. Now, I think that Step Back Jay the Rapper, he could do better with his comment, because if he left something a little more about what they would see in the video, or a little more about why he made the song, or a funny story about what happened in the video, that to me would be more engaging and draw me into going to see the video. I doubt that anybody really, unless they fell in love with him like in an instant, went to see the video. I don't think my bet is that they didn't click through to see it. And he maybe got one click from a female who liked his picture. If you were to leave more interesting information in the description box that really like spurs interest, then you're more likely to get that click through to that video. All right, so we're 30 minutes in, and those are my three tips. Let me see if I missed anything. So that $1.80 Instagram strategy for faster growth, it's like whether it goes down in your DM or you go and comment on people's top posts, which you have to do both of, by the way. I definitely, think you should do both of. I weigh my relationships from stories in the DM, but the comments that are happening on my posts are the ones that are visible. And I feel that those ones inspire others. So keep that in mind when you're choosing to post. But as far as if you every single day left your 2 cents on 9 trending Instagram posts for 10 different hashtags, that would add up to $1.80 worth of information from you that is quality left out there as breadcrumbs back to your Instagram page. That is that whole strategy. If you do that several times a day, like 3 times a day, once in the morning, once in the evening, once at night, and you post 2 times a day, you are well underway to having an amazing Instagram strategy and being able to do well on this app. So guys, I hope that was some words of wisdom for you. I really hope that just get you to where you want to go. I am going to be going over to my personal channel, Jacqueline Jacks, to go and attempt to make a video on this is your time. Don't miss it. All right. Have a great one. And I'll be back again very, very shortly. Don't forget, there are Instagram hacks all over the YouTube channel. I've got lots and lots of videos for you to study up on. So binge watch. And don't forget to leave me a comment below. See you later.